Embedded C program to interface LCD with PIC microcontroller. Here port B of PIC microcontroller is connected to D0 to D7 lines of LCD, that is 16 by 2 LCD. The RS terminal, resistor select terminal of LCD, is connected to RC0 terminal of PIC microcontroller. Enable terminal is connected to RC1 of PIC microcontroller, and since we always going to perform write operation, R/W bar terminal is connected to permanently ground. So no need to use R/W bar in program. This resistor is connected to change the brightness of this LCD. Now we are going to write program to display a first name. You can display your first name on first row of this LCD. I am going to display FIRST in the first row. F will be written at first character position, that is at address ATH. And in the second row, you can display your last name. I am going to display here LAST. L will be displayed at first character position of second row, that is at address C0H. First, include PIC microcontroller file P18F4550.h. Then we'll define enable terminal. So for enable terminal, I'll use name LCD_enable, and enable terminal is connected to RC1 terminal of PIC microcontroller. So we'll write here port C bits dot RC1. So instead of writing port C bits dot RC1, we'll use name LCD_EN. So for that, we have used here directives #define. Similarly, for RS terminal, we'll use this define LCD_RS and mention here port terminal. So port C bits dot RC0. So instead of writing this RC0 every time, we can use this name LCD_RS for RS terminal. Then we need delay, a small delay in program. So first we'll write function. So all functions which we require we'll write first, and then we'll write to main program. So I will declare here variable unsigned integer I, and we'll write a simple for loop for I is equal to 0, I is less than 5000, I plus plus. So small delay we can call in main program. Then globally we'll declare strings which we want to display on first row and second row. So I'll declare first string unsigned character string 1, any name you can give to this variable, equal to whatever string you want to display, that you can write here. So I want to display first on first row of LCD. The string is of 5 character. Length of string is 5. 5 characters we want to display. Similarly, we can declare string. We are declaring it globally, that's why it is written here. You can declare it locally also in main function, string 2. And in second row, I want to display last. Give here semicolon. So last string is of 4 character, that will be displayed on second row of LCD. Then we need two functions. One function to write the command in command register, and second function to write a data in data register. So first we will write function. You can give any name to function. I am giving name as send command. An argument for this function will be a command which we want to write in command register. So for that I will declare it as an unsigned character. So that will be 8-bit. And any name you can give to this variable. So I will give name as a command. So command parameter will be passed by main function to this send command function. So in send command function, first we have to select RS terminal, that is register. So we want to select command register. So for command register, RS terminal must be 0. So by initializing 0 to LCD RS, the RC0 pin will be at logic 0 and command register will be selected. After this, we can call small delay function which we have written already. After this, whatever data you want to send in command register, you want to store in command register, that data should be placed on data bus. Port B is connected to data bus, and to latch this data, enable terminal should be at logic 1 and 0. That is high to low pulse we have to send at enable terminal. So first we'll send logic 1 to enable terminal. We'll call small delay. Then place data, that is command in this case, on port B. So port B is equal to command. Whatever command we want to write, that will be passed by main function to this. So this command will place on port B. Call some delay function. And to latch this command on data line or on port B, first enable terminal is at logic 1. Now you can send logic 0 to enable terminal. That means we are sending high to low pulse on enable terminal. After this, again we can call delay and end this function. Similar function we can write to write data in data register. Only difference is that here the register you have to select as a data register, and to select data register, LCD_RS terminal should at logic 1. To write a function to write data in data register, send data name I am using for this function. You can use any name. And again we have to pass a data to this function. To this variable, I'll give name as LCD data. So this variable will come to this function from main program. So again, first step is select register, that is data register. So LCD_RS should be at logic 1. Call small delay. Send enable pulse at logic 1, call delay, and now on port B we have to send data. So that is in variable LCD data. So we'll write here LCD data. So LCD data, the data is, data means ASCII value of character which we want to display, that is stored in port B. Call delay and then send LCD enable logic 0. Call some delay and end this routine. We have written delay function, then command function, data function. Now write to main program. So I'll write here void main. First we have to declare variable, so unsigned character will declare variable afterwards as required. Now first thing is decide direction of port terminal. So port B we are using to for sending data or command, so we'll initialize it to 00, that is port B is used as a output port. Then ports terminal C0 and C1 again we are using as a output terminal for enable and RS, so we'll declare it as a output bit. Same for RC1, uses at as a output bit. So this decide the direction of this port terminals. Then we have to initialize LCD. So for that we'll send command 30 at edge. So directly we can use function send command. Now first command generally we use 0x38, that is select 16x2 LCD. So that value, that parameter or command we have to send to send command function which we have already written. Then second command we want to write is 0EH. Already we have discussed this in previous videos. And next command, third command is 0x01, that is to clear a display. So these three commands we always send to LCD to initialize LCD. Now continuously we want to display two string on LCD, so the remaining program we have to write in infinite loop. So we'll write here while 1, and the first I want to display string first on first row of LCD, so F will be displayed at character position 80H. If you want to change this character position, you have to change this address. So I will send first the address of first character where I want to display first character to command. So this command will be written in LCD command register. Then we want to display this 5 characters one by one. ASCII value of each character we want to store in data register. So for that we'll use a for loop. So for I is equal to 0 to I is less than 5, so it will start from 0 up to 4 I plus plus. So since we have used I here, I'll declare here unsigned character I. Then read data from string. String 1 we have declared. So string 1 is stored as an array, and we'll write here ith character position of string 1. So it will read the ith character from string. When I is 0, it will read F, ASCII value of F. When I is 1, it will read ASCII value of, like that. And this value will assign to variable, any variable we can use. I'll use suppose here variable P. So P variable again we have to declare. So P will have ASCII value of character in the string, and this P we want to write in data register. So we'll use command send data and send this parameter P to data. So that will be written, and the F letter will be displayed on LCD. So continuously if we execute this loop, the FIRST will be displayed on first position. After displaying first string, now we want to display a second string. So again for that we have to use for loop. For I is equal to 0, I is less than 5, I plus plus. Now before that, here we have to send address of first character of second string. So this is last string we want to display. So first character we want to display at address C0H. So for that, here we have to send command. Send command and send address, that is 0xC0. So whatever string now you want to display, that will display starting from this address 0sh. Then we'll use for loop, and again I'll use the same variable p is equal to, now this time we want to read array string array 2. So I'll write here 2 I position. And since this string contains only 4 characters, here we have to use as a 4. It starts from 0, so 0, 1, 2, 3. So if it is less than 4, you can stop. And again send this to this function, send data. So this ASCII value of character will be displayed on LCD. If we want, after doing this we can call a delay program and then end this while loop and end main function. End while loop and end main function. Here we have declared two variables, so you can end this also.